Hello. In the last lecture, we discussed about the night shelters and the pavement dwellers and what kind of interventions we can take for the pavement dwellers. Today, we will discuss under lecture 35 the details about the old age home. So, before I come to the details of the old age home, let me quickly recap what we just mentioned about the night shelters and the pavement dwellers. We mentioned that the pavement dwellers are the people by and large they are individual persons coming from the rural background or from the smaller cities because of the extreme poverty and because of the family abandonment and all those social and related problem. They come to the bigger city for the search of the livelihood and the job, but they end up in living in the streets and the public areas because they do not get the formal house and they do not get the capability or the affordability to afford a formal house. So, for this type of people they are by and large individual persons kind of a beggars, and also they are surviving on the street vending. So, we can have three approaches for these people separately and also in integration. Like, we can give them shelters for their night sleeping, we can call it as a night shelter. The second approach could be that we can provide only the infrastructure and services free of cost or maybe nominal cost, like sanitation, water supply, all the services. And third approach could be livelihood option. We can improve their livelihood and job prospect and job situation by giving different kind of innovative mechanism, and also we can give interventions considering these three elements of their life cycle. And the issues we identified, also the main issues were the location in the city core areas or in the around the business district. We do not find much areas to create the night shelter because night shelter takes a good amount of place or the land area. The second issue was the target group. The night shelter we have built so far is unable to satisfy the problem like the single women or the family or physically disabled person or mentally retarded person. For this kind of people, we can develop separate kind of night shelter, separate kind of typologies, and also considering the space constraint, we can also improvise and develop and design a kind of a movable solution of the for the night solution of the shops, or movable solution even also for the night shelter as a temporary solution, as a kinetic element of the kinetic structure. So, those kind of solutions is provided, and most of all we told that we need a comprehensive and holistic action plan at every level to address the issue of the night shelter of the pavement dwellers. But definitely there are macro issues like why people are coming from the rural areas to the urban areas at a larger scale. So, at the macro level, macro scale, those issues need to be addressed. Otherwise, only at the city level or at the local level, it may not be possible to solve 100% of the problem. So, with this note, we will discuss another very important part of the housing planning, that is the old age housing. Now, before we come to the main topic, let me tell about the background why old age housing or homes have come up in today's time in a very large number in the cities. So, there are various reasons. One reason is that in today's time the families, you will find that the nuclear families, earlier in the 10 or 20 years back in India, we used to see the joint families or the bigger family. So, now we have seen that there is a visible change from the joint family to nuclear family. That is number one reason. So, as a effect of the conversion from the joint family to the nuclear family, what we are finding that in a nuclear family, once the current generation, the younger person, they go out, the older people person, they becomes lonely or they have to stay alone because their children, their staying other places in other cities for their jobs. And another reason for aggravating this problem is that the size of the family, from the bigger family to very small or family. So average family size when it was 5 to 6, now average family size between 3 to 4. So because of this problem is also aggravated, because the younger people are outside, they are going outside for their job. So that is one reason. The third reason is that in some of the cases we have seen that old age people or the senior citizens, they are also deprived of their due respect, and not only respect, sometime they are humiliated by their children, said they don't get their basic living need. Because of that, we have found that in many cities, the old age people and the senior citizens, they are living in extremely difficult life situation. Another reason which basically added to this situation is that there are the old age people, they have investable surplus, or they have at least some amount of investable surplus which they can invest in a second home or a old age home. That is another reason. Few decades back we did not have those kind of investable surplus, and now because of the various improved mechanism of the housing finance and the investment schemes, there are possibility that at the young age, if you invest your savings, after some period you will get a substantial money by which you can do whatever you want, and you can also purchase a old age home. So that is another reason, that because of the savings and also pension schemes, which led to the investable surplus that they can invest for the second home. Another reason for this particular old age home and its expansion is that the average mortality and life expectancy has grown up, and mortality has gone down because of that, because of the improvement of the medical facility, improvement of the medical care in today's time, especially in the cities, under the government and the private healthcare facility. So as a result of that, the life expectancy has gone up. The people after their superannuation at the age of 65, they are living say 85 years. So because of that, they need a concrete plan, a concrete intervention, concrete mechanism, so that at the older age they can live properly, they can live with comparatively better ease and better facility, and with all respect and the basic living need. So as a result of that, they are very much interested to please take a note here that we are not discussing a general trend, but it is the trend in the city area where we find all these problems. But yes, right now there are joint families, there are families where older people are taken care of and they are living properly within the family. So they might not need the old age home, but the reasons we are discussing, because of this reason, some of the older people, they are sometimes bound to, they are forced to come to the old age home for their better living. Now, this old age home is kind of a different type of home which can be designed differently, because there could be three different category of the old age home depending on their capacity. Now, old age home should have additional facility for the old age people. So, one could be the independent unit, and based on their dependency, other could be like dependent unit. So, in independent unit, they can stay independently without any help. But think of a situation that old age people after 65 or 60 years, they need some kind of assistance because of their physical inability, because of their disease, because of their ailings, they might need some assistance. So, for that need, they need various categories of dependent unit, various degrees of dependent units, like say assisted, it is called as a assisted living. They might need a assistance or attendant to help them their day to day works. So, those kind of units are designed. So, in a particular old age home complex, it could be combining of a combination of the only independent unit, or it can be combination of all categories. So, now let us see that the overall situation of the old age home in India, and we will see one case study for better understanding. So, this is the situation of the old age home. You can see at a glance the overall picture, how the India as a whole has the old age home. Now, 100% information are not available, but whatever information is collected from the various data, we have seen that there are around more than 700 old age home, and out of that around 550 old age homes information are available. The basically out of this around 300 homes are free of cost, within while 95 old age homes are on pay and stay basis. In most of the cases, free of cost old age homes are provided by the government itself, state government, but otherwise for the private organization, they provide old age home on a payment and stay basis. And around 116 homes have both free as well as pay and stay facilities based on the economic category or the economic capability, and 11 homes have no information. So, so that is the overall picture. Now, we can see that around 300 old age homes are available for the sick people who are terminally ill with a robust medical support, and around 100 old age homes are exclusively meant for the women, because they are a single or older women who are basically living as a widow. So, for them around 100 old age homes are there. In Kerala, we have seen the major amount of 120 or 24 old age home. Now, we must discuss a relevant act related to old age home. The act is called the Maintenance and the Welfare of Parents and Senior Citizens Act 2007. This is a very important act, which the objective of this act is to ensure the right and their basic need of the old age people from their family and from the society. So, this act tells you that it provides for maintenance and welfare of parents and senior citizens, and ensures maintenance of their livelihood. The both is combined here, that is the shelter component and their livelihood component. Apart from that, it ensures a maximum maintenance allowance, mandatory maintenance allowance from the children's, like the tribunal can award maximum maintenance allowance of rupees 10,000 per month depending on the situation. So even if the childrens they are not taking adequate care for the for their parents, so the court or the act provides the provision to force them or to make them provide mandatory allocation for the maintenance allowance. Apart from that, the act gives the protection to the senior citizen transferring their property by the way of gift or otherwise his property, subject to the condition that the transferee shall provide the basic amenities and basic physical needs to the transferor. If he refuses or fails to provide them, all such transfers can be declared as void if they are made as a result of fraud or coercion. Now, why this is made? Because the older people who are having their own property like land or building, so there could be effort, and we have seen in the past history that there are efforts to take the property from them by force or by the fraudulent activity. So to stop this activity, it is given that even if the property is given by gift or any or otherwise also, the subject to condition that the transferee shall provide all the basic amenities. So even if the property is given to his children or the other persons, so those persons who are getting the property, they have to provide the amenities, basic amenities and facilities which is required for their life, including the medical cost. So that is a very important part of this act, which protects their right of the property and right of their living. You can see this example. We'll tell you some examples. So this type of old age home, it needs nursing care. It could be done by the organization. Some social events and group activities is also required in addition to giving the regular meals. Now we discussed that there could be three different type of element. I mean typologies. One could be independent, who can stay or live without any help. The second part is the dependent unit. Such person share the common facilities like say cooking facilities or the mess facilities, and there could be assisted living. It is also basically a dependent unit, but it is called assisted because here they need more amount of the assistance in terms of the medical care and the physical care. Okay, now this is one example we have shown just to take a idea that how it can be designed. Though it looks like a typical other group housing project, but this project was designed as a old age housing or senior citizen housing near about Delhi. So these are the typologies design, different typologies designed for the project. You can see the few more projects. Though the typologies seems to be designed as a normal kind of a normal dwelling unit like 2 BHK or 1 BHK or 3 BHK, but please take a note that the internal spaces including their furniture arrangement and the specification and their all circulation spaces need to be designed very minutely with the help of the concept of the universal design and the accessibility barrier free design, so that at any point of time they do not face any barriers from accessing to one room to another room, or from the lobby area, common area to the room, or also accessing to the facilities like toilet and kitchen. So this kind of design element should be there. So we talked about the design consideration. So age friendly design and fittings like carved wall edges, mat non-slip tiles in the bathroom, night lamp in the master bedroom, grab rails in the toilet corridors, emergency alarm, all these are required for the as a design element. Activity center has indoor games, hobby classes, talks and interactive sessions. This is much more required because of their psychological attachment and the psychological well-being. Now there could be club facility. This club facility gives the social interaction and leisure activities. There could be regular health camps and checkups on site by the organizer, and plus emergency care and doctor on call and ambulance could be arranged for this for these people. You can see some of the glimpse of the old age people how they are living in this particular campus. Few more pictures you can understand. So these are the common play area, common activity area, landscaped areas where they spend their time in the evening or in the afternoon. so that they do not feel that they are isolated, they are in a within a community. So, having said that, let us summarize the discussion today. Today we discussed a very important part of the housing planning, that is the old age home. There are various reasons for developing the old age home. The first reason what we discuss is the conversion from the joint family to the nuclear family. Second reason we discuss that the bigger family to the smaller family, more nuclear family, and as a result of that, when the younger people going outside for their job requirement, the older person, they are living lonely and without any assistance, and sometimes they are deprived of their due respect and the basic living need from their family. And another reason is that because of the saving schemes and the pension scheme, they have the capability and affordability to have the second second house. And another reason is that because of the improvement of the health facility and the healthcare services at the government level and at the private level, the life expectancy is growing and the mortality is going down. Because as a result of that, more and more number of old age people, they are having a need of old age home. So we discussed that three categories of old age home is possible. One is dependent category, where old age people or senior citizens can stay independently without any assistance. There could be dependent unit at the first category needs the some common facilities like kitchen, mess facility, some common health facility, community services, etc. And also there could be assisted living, where the dependency is much more higher. The in that category, along with the old age home, separate room can be provided for the attendant and the assistants who are basically there to help them in day to day living, for their medical need, for their assisting in the physical circulation from one place to another place, and various kinds of other physical need. So, considering that, we have seen one case study where we have seen that the design of the building units and the house and the open space areas will be in such a way so that they do not feel at any point of time isolated, and they feel that they are within a community. So, more so apart from the design, including the age friendly design, and there could be various kinds of events and the activities which can be organized at the site, so that they feel that that they are within a community and they are having a good times. And at the same time, we discussed the maintenance and management of the Senior Citizens Act 2007. Under this act, we have discussed that two major provisions are there. One provision is to mandatory allowance for the maintenance allowance for the senior citizen. This can be mandatory by the children or any other person who are taking care of the old age people. Second, the provision which is very important is that the protection of the property. Even if any old age people, they sell or they provide gift that property to anybody, including their children, the condition is that after the gifting of the property, they have to take care of their all the basic need, including the living need, including the living and the medical expenses. So, this act basically ensures the right of the older and the senior citizen people. Now, the major trend in the current housing market is that the old age home is a trend. It is the requirement for the time, for the day. But the thing is, there are people who may not afford two different set of house, like one earlier house and another old age home at the later period of their time. So the objective is, or the major trend is, whether we can design the housing projects, the normal group housing or the privately built housing project, in such a way so that in future we do not have to convert them as a old age home. We can augment them, we can just adapt them as a old age home with some element of the design intervention, so that we do not have to sell that house and shift to another old age home. So, those kind of trends are coming up in bigger way in the cities. So, the major learning from this lecture is that we have to have a basic aptitude to design the old age home, considering their need, the legal implication and their design requirement. So, those who are interested to develop a specialization on this particular subject, they can do it, because this is the very important feature which is coming in a big way in the near future. So, with this note, we conclude this discussion. The next discussion, next lecture, we will discuss another very important part of the housing planning, that is disaster resistant housing. We have seen that for all the natural hazards and the disaster, the houses or the shelters are the very important part which get affected, and because of that the human casualty and the property loss is there. So, how we can through the planning and design we can achieve disaster resistant housing, so that we can minimize extremely the loss, human loss and the property loss at every level, at the local level, state level and every geographical location. So, with this we conclude this lecture. So, thank you for your attention.